We live in an interesting and pretty dynamic time. This fact was proved once again by the Chinese, who launched the Chang'e 4 automatic interplanetary station to study the reverse side of the moon. The moon has always interested Earthlings more than other celestial bodies, and now the big time has come. Now humanity will surely find out what hides on the so-called dark side of the moon, which, by the way, is illuminated by the sun no less than the light one. The Chang'e 4 lander, named after the Chinese pantheon lunar goddess, successfully launched from the Zhejiang Cosmodrome on December 7, 2018, while aboard a Long March 3B launch vehicle. On January 3, 2019, in the early morning after a 26-day flight, Chang'e 4 made a soft landing on the lunar surface. The mission started as a sensation. Soon, Chang'e 4 sent a series of excellent panoramic images of the moon in its natural form to Earth. Here's the moon gallery. This is the historical photo taken by the stationary module. Now take a close look. What is it? The wheel of the lunar rover before it left the overpass. And here are the images showing how the U22 rover carefully slides into the lunar dust. Look intently at this photo. It shows how the lunar rover begins to move. A landmark video was also shot that captured the moment of landing. Right now, you're watching a fragment of video from the onboard camera that captured the moment of the moon landing. A link to the full version is provided in the description. The first pictures shocked the world. It turned out that the color of the dust of the moon isn't the same as expected. According to the photo, the lunar views are more like a reddish Martian landscape. Later, the reason became clear. The image was made by uncalibrated cameras, hence the unusual effect. It's explained relatively simply. If you set different color temperature parameters on the camera equipment, the images may differ in both warm and cool shades. Let's give an example. Now the camera is set to a temperature of 2,500 kelvins. Let's see what happened as a result. Now let's try to take the same photo, but with the parameters of 10,000 kelvins. The effect is obvious. The same object, identical lighting, but there's a difference in the highlight. How to understand if the camera is calibrated correctly? For example, in the image of the Apollo 17 mission, a special multicolored marker is seen in the frame, which you can use to orient. On the right, there is an orange spot of land, although the rest of the landscape is gray. Next to it, we see an image with natural calibration. This photo of the lunar rover is from the TIK camera. Obviously, there is no redness, and now you have a view from the rover to the stationary module. It's noticeable that the shades slightly differ, since the lunar rover has a camera with different calibration settings. But most importantly, we have the first full 360-degree panorama of the landing site. You can find the full resolution version of the panorama in the description so that you can see the full-scale version in detail and enjoy the harsh lunar beauty. The landing site of the interplanetary station was the ancient impact crater of Theodore von Karman. It's part of a global formation called the South Pole Aitken Basin. It's the largest crater on the moon and in the solar system. Its dimensions are 2,400 by 2,050 kilometers, and its depth varies from 8 to 16 kilometers. Before landing, Chang'e 4 first used the technology of preliminary scanning of the terrain to determine the most acceptable landing location. It's worth noting that the launch of Chang'e 4 is part of China's lunar program, which involves a phased study of the moon. The mission consists of three stages. The second intermediate stage is aimed at organizing soft landings of lunar rovers on the moon. The last stage of the program is planned for this year. Now let's get back to U22. A few hours after the lunar landing, the Chinese 140-kilogram Jade Hare 2 rover moved unhindered from the lander and safely fell into a week-long hibernation. Meanwhile, the Chang'e 4 station passed a long fire test. The lunar day turned out to be a hot thing. What is the lunar rover equipped with to perform its task efficiently? It's literally stuffed with useful things. 4 panoramic cameras, the georadar for probing regolith layers, an infrared spectrometer, and an atomic analyzer that calculates the intensity of interaction between the solar wind and the lunar surface. All devices were developed by the best engineering labs in the world. For example, the radiometer was created by German specialists. It will help measure the degree of radiation attacks that future astronauts will be exposed to. The energy potential of the lunar rover is supported by an atomic source that works due to the decay of plutonium-238. What hopes do scientists have for the U-22 lunar rover? First of all, this is a fence and soil study. Experts hope to find fragments of rock on the moon knocked out by meteorites from under the upper layers of the mantle. This will shed some light on the geological structure of the moon. The lunar rover will also measure the temperature amplitudes of day and night and try to find water. Among other things, the mission will allow scientists to test the capabilities of deep space communications and conduct low-frequency radio astronomy observations, because on the reverse side of the moon, interference from the Earth isn't a problem for the equipment. This will shed light on understanding the nature of radiation that was present in the early stages of the universe. To hear the Chang'e 4 station, which is located outside the line of sight, a quick Quio relay satellite was launched. Its name literally translates as Magpie Bridge. The probe entered orbit at the Lagrange point, making it equally visible from Earth and the Moon. What did the little U-22 do during this time? We don't want to disappoint you, but the rover was mostly asleep. After coming out of hibernation mode on January 10, 2019, U-22 was busy doing a photo session for 4 days. And on January 14th, with the onset of a harsh lunar night, the device and the lander fell into a life-saving hibernation again. Because as soon as the sun's rays stop illuminating the surface of the moon, the temperature there drops to minus 190 degrees. On January 29, the rover finally continued its mission. The most important experiment, which has no analogs in the history of cosmonautics, was a biological experiment with plants and insect eggs. A container simulating the conditions of the artificial biosphere is installed on board the station. In the pressure chamber was placed land, water, air, potato seeds, rapeseed, Arabidopsis, cotton, Rosophila eggs, and yeast fungi. The heat controller maintains a constant temperature of plus 25 degrees Celsius in the container. After the Chang'e 4 landed, the seeds were immediately watered, and what a miracle! 12 days later, the cameras recorded the germination of cotton. This is a major breakthrough, because this has never happened on the surface of another celestial body. Due to the onset of the moonlit night, the support mode was disabled and the experiment ended, but the beginning was made. Research in this area will be expanded and supplemented. This will help to gain experience for the organization of future lunar bases, which will have to create such ecosystems. The mission made China famous. No spacecraft has ever landed on the far side of the moon before, but the lunar rover will have a difficult task. On February 27, the Xinhua news agency reported that the spacecraft encountered the first difficulties associated with the complex terrain of the lunar surface. Despite the presence of 6 maneuverable wheels and 4-wheel drive base, the U-22 is difficult to move. So the team is slightly puzzled and looking for acceptable routes for the lunar rover. Obstacles are unavoidable, and the flight organizers didn't expect the mission to be easy. One thing is important. A detailed study of the reverse side of the moon was undertaken not to find evidence of a lunar conspiracy, but to make life easier for future colonists who will find themselves in an alien, aggressive, and extreme environment. A new era of space exploration and the preparation of a manned mission to the moon has begun. This gives us hope that our descendants will be able to fly to neighboring planets on vacation. We hope you enjoyed this video, and in gratitude, you'll give it an thumbs up, subscribe, and click on the bell. This is very important because you'll get the latest updates. Finally, let's play a little interactive game. Answer this question: which planet would you choose for tourism, and why? Write your answers under this video.